Oh yeah, the vault run is it's crazy. But the cooldown on it is fucked.
Yeah, but you can just hop on the Bill's jobs.
Yeah, yeah, you can be the mule. That's what we came up with, the mule.
Oh, wait, so what we're doing now seems pretty arduous, no?
Yeah, sometimes you get a bad seed. I mean, a bad job.
No, it's a seed. Because they get a bunch of employees, bunch of bags, bunch of banks, right? And they give you a randomized set of places to go. That is what it is.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, that's how I think of it. But
because you know, people don't want to get robbed. They don't want employees to get robbed. So if they give them a linear course, robbers are going to know where to go when.
Yeah, exactly.
Body, yada, yeah.
Yeah, sometimes it's only 4 ATMs and they're like all right next to each other. When the job is like 10 minutes.
Hey, you called me?
Yeah, you still want the run or no?
No, he just called me. I'm not doing it because I got busy doing like a bunch of other runs at the same time. But thank you though. I have his number now, so I can come and do, you can do whatever. Thank you.
Okay, cool.
Alright, I'll see you later, bye.
Two more.
Yo. No, it's already in there. Yo, so do you put the rates on this or what?
Sorry?
Do you put the rates on this or what?
The rates?
Yeah, like people said like they put the rates on those. Like they put like a number on that.
Yo, oh, you gotta like move. A fee.
Yeah.
Like a fee. Yeah, I own 2 ATMs. I don't own that one.
So how long do you own it for?
Forever. Unless you don't maintain it. I have the one, you know the convenience store in Grapeseed?
Yeah.
I have that one because when people do weed runs and shit or buy weed stuff, yeah, they're paying cash. So if they don't have it on hand, I gotta use my ATM.
That's busted. Yo!
Yo, eggs. Have you looked at the HQ app, bro?
No, what about it?
Bro, Anita is at 100%, but I don't know if that's scuffed or what, dude.
No, it's probably the distribution of density at that spot.
Yeah, exactly. So Anita is like at number one when we haven't even sold shit in 2 days, right?
Wait.
Bro, we haven't sold anything there.
So and like all either the other percentages- seller 2 went hard, or the density is per period of time. So let's say it's like 3 days per period, right? Whoever sold before us hasn't sold anything yet. And the only sold stuff is our stuff. So Anita becomes number one at 100% density, no? Or is that not how that works?
I'm really not sure because here's one more thing that I wanted to tell you about this tug of war shit, okay? So last night, PD had like 3 people selling, okay?
Yeah.
We had 1 or 2, everyone, and our percentages still went up. You get me?
No, still one more time.
Okay. The fucking Lang and the boys, yeah?
Yeah.
They had 3 people selling, okay? It was PD and like some of his other goons and shit. We had KJ and seller number 2 selling, okay? 2v3, yeah. All right? It was 2v2. And our percentages went up. And theirs didn't go down. You get me?
Yeah, yeah.
And I talked to seller number 2. The only thing that drops our rep right now, and we both agree on this, for now, is if people sell the stolen Zaza. So we have a few hundred bags that been stolen, and some with decks, some with fucking probably like Speedy and shit. And if that shit got sold, it would tank our rep.
Makes sense, yeah.
And there's still hundreds out there, bro. That's why I don't believe it's a tug of war until they drop to like fucking 80% or some shit.
Yeah, okay. But it makes sense. But thank you for clearing my doubt. I can't say that. Thank you enough, man. You guys really helped me out with this.
Bro, Ray last night reached 100K. I told him, bro, just please sell. Because we've been selling the computers, bro. He's been selling like mad too. Bro, we've been selling the shit. I'm at 27K, bro. I went into debt just like you. And fucking OTT is at like 50K. He just bought the Packer. Bro, everybody making money.
I just made like thousands of dollars in minutes with G6. It's ridiculous.
I know, I know. Listen, I'll send you a picture about G6 later when I drop you guys off there. Very nice.
Like, it's so dumb how much it is.
Bro, you know it's 2,000 every 15 minutes, right?
No, 13 minutes.
Oh, yeah, well, there you go. Yeah, apparently it's 13 minutes. There was a world speedrun record at 12, right?
That's mine. Stream
win. That's yours?
Yeah.
How the fuck did you get a speedrun record your first day?
I mean, bro, my hands move so fast that the people can't even see them.
Well, Ray fucking clutched it up yesterday, man. He kept on making sales, and then I think he knew it was just a good idea to clear you up. So
yeah, well, thank you, man. I'll just
thank Ray too. Thank everybody, bro. Everybody working hard.
I will.
Okay, I'll see you. Just give me a call if you need help with anything. I'm doing some runs.
Okay, thank you, man.
Bye bye.
See you, man. Yo, in my eyes, like since I'm not the one who kind of maybe failed the last ATM. In my eyes, we have four more to do, but we only have three.
No, we have four.
Oh, they're stacked on top of one another, probably?
Yeah.
I see it.
Yeah, if you get really lucky, you know, depending on the job Mr. Armstrong gives you, you can get four literally right next to each other and go back to HQ.
Thanks, Voltic Line, I see that. Land splits. What is this guy doing? So what have you been doing? Hold on.
Making money. That's about it. I'm waiting for that website. I can't open the casino. So that's a kind of on hold. You know?
So how much money you got?
Like 130.
Man, everybody's so fucking rich, it's unbelievable. I guess if I didn't have my fines for fucking 60k and I didn't do dumb shit, I'd be kind of nearby, but even then, it's still been not close.
You'd probably have more. You'd have more than me. Thing is, you let yourself live in this fucking comfortable bubble because you have people you can call that get you out of fucking debt whenever you get in it, and that's stupid.
Yeah, but
putting yourself in a position to stay comfortable.
At the same time, though, there's not much I could have done for money, and I was banned from all the fucking places that I've worked. And also, we worked really hard to get ahead of certain markets and make money off of that shit.
Yeah, and that's the thing, right? And then you guys didn't adjust. You guys didn't adjust to the market, right?
Well, I mean, there's no more money to be made at anymore.
No, there was. There absolutely was. You were selling racks for 20K when they should have been valued at 8K. I sold $100,000 worth of racks in a day selling them at 8K.
Yeah, but you understand it. You can burn through your crops in a day, right? Or you can carefully size your market and drip feed it for way more. You understand it, like?
Yeah, and you didn't do that. You didn't, bro. You didn't do that.
What do you mean?
Treated your market like garbage. It was extremely short term. You think day by day.
XQCL.
Huh? That's the last one.
No, hold on. Hold on. What I'm telling you is, right, it takes more time and it's more labor overall, right? But like it.
No, because you could have sold it. Okay. If you could have sold those blueprints, right? For 5, 6, 7K and made way more sales than trying to sell the actual built rack for 20, 25, 15. These prices are ridiculous.
So I really think that you need to look into concepts such as a complementary market or something like that. A product that, it's a bit complicated. I don't know if you've ever done a microeconomics or whatever, right?
Yeah.
It's like, usually use the example of the Tostitos and the salsa, okay? People are gonna want Tostitos and salsa, yeah?
Yes.
So, by selling the fucking blueprints, you're selling the Tostitos, right?
Okay.
By selling the bill thing, you sell the tostitos and the salsa. You understand?
Yeah, I would agree. I would agree. But the thing is, okay, when you sell the blueprint, they think, oh shit, I have a mining rack blueprint. I'm good to fucking go. I don't have to ever buy this shit again. They buy it, they build it, and then they go, fuck. All right? Fuck. It's only one goddamn fucking rack I can make this blueprint. I don't know how to do anything else. Then they call you and say, fuck, buy another blueprint. Can I buy more racks just straight off you? And then at that point, you already have them reeled in. Foot in the door phenomena. All right? And then you upcharge them afterwards and say, all right, it was 8K for this blueprint, but I'll build it for you, but it's going to cost me 15K because it's a pain in the ass. And they'll realize it was 100 planks to build and the 200 alloy, and it was a pain in the ass for them, and they don't want to get a new blueprint every single fucking time and keep falling back.
True,
like,
true.
Right, fuck it, I'll buy five.
These are the degens. I'm pretty sure you probably either got one or two of these guys. That's like a rare gem of a customer. Like the degens that buy 10 racks, there's not like a lot of them. You cannot have one or two customers that go degen mode and call that a market. That's like, that's a customer, not a market.
Thank you for the welcome to
right?
the jungle, Mr. Cow.
Sure. Sure. All right, how about this?
You're doing the same thing as Buddha did. Well, coming at us being like, oh, dude, people are dumb buying like fucking three desks for like 100K, whatever the fuck. And then we're like, yeah, you're right. But like, when you find the customer that's stupid, I mean, milk him, right? That doesn't mean that the market is like that, but we're gonna milk the fucking cow if we can. Yeah?
Okay. But the thing is, you guys were milking cows for weeks. You should have been doing it for days at most. That's my point. Like, what do you value Buttcoin at? Per one coin, how much is it?
Again. So the way that plays out is, I think, more complicated than you think it is. So I really said
No. I think it's extremely complicated.
The market changes daily for a multitude of reasons. And right now it's at a flat, right? But it'll skyrocket. And also flatten out like really, really fast when there's something we could use it for, right? At certain varying time frames. You get it?
Yeah.
So like, it's just about if it's gonna be something that you buy that's like a repetition, or something you buy that's like a chunk. If it's a repetition, right? Then you get them hooked with one or two of it, right? And they want way more. Yeah, you can. It's gonna like fit in some crack. But if it's a big one, you might price it really high because, like, shit, it's a big chunk, you know. I mean, losing purchasing power, and it's not a very appealing for us to lose a lot of butt at the same time, you know.
Yeah. What's good?
It's a little bit like Genie back in the days, you know. Like, if you find this guy for 20, this guy for 30, this guy for 30, that's fine, whatever, right? But whenever there was not a lot of genie, finding a guy to sell you fucking 250 genie back in the days, in a chunk, oof, like, you know, when there was a lot of it, I mean, they're gonna chuck it for that shit.
Yeah.
Depends though. I don't know. Right now we're sitting on tons of butt. I mean, we even stopped making fucking racks because, I mean, why bother?
You're still making racks?
Of course not.
Oh, I thought you were saying you still were.
Nobody even fucking get materials anymore. Nobody even gets them or sell them.
I can sell you materials.
I mean, how much did that shit sell for? I see people selling that for three.
Circuit boards for three per?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah, I've been seeing that, yeah.
Oh, then I can't match that.
Well, I'm saying nobody gets them and nobody sells them. Like it's a void market.
I got this one. Don't worry. Other one up here, probably.
Up here, yeah.
Bricks. Put your fucking hands up.
Okay.
Put your hands up. Why the fuck are you taking bags out of my fucking truck?
Hey, don't rob me.
What are you talking about? $1.
You took three bags out of my fucking truck.
What?
I won't fucking play stupid. There was no one else around.
What is he talking about?
The three bags just disappear out of my truck?
Yo, does this happen often, bro? What is
he
talking about?
No, these guys are just fucking delinquents, man.
Okay, whatever.
We're delinquents.
Yeah, so you're gonna rob your own fucking peers, bro, right?
Yeah, because you're just going to drive around and talk shit to them, right?
Yeah, because you crashed into me, right?
You were on the wrong side of the road.
You're going 80 miles per hour inside, back into the headquarters.
I wasn't going 80 miles per hour. You were on the wrong side of the road.
It's all right, man.
Shit happens. Don't be a prick.
Hey, do your thing. Do your thing. Do your thing.
Hey, man. Hey, man. Listen. We're sorry about the disagreement. Listen, we didn't do nothing. But I understand you feel that way, man. I'm sorry about that. Yeah, these guys like what's up?
You take your bags, you good?
Oh, I still got them. Yeah. But you know what's crazy, right?
I've never even fucking met those guys before.
Hey, man, you wanna hear something crazy? One reason I folded and I'm mad about it. Like, we know where we threw the bags out. They don't. So like, we could just pick them up.
You have three?
I got two, but I know where all the others are at. Go and pick it up. So this slowed us down by a minute and a half, which is kind of upsetting, but I mean, it is what it is.
Probably more, like 3 minutes.
Also, I think this guy, if he wants to be like a G6 gangster, should probably not roll with any bright blue truck. Or was that him or was it somebody else? It was him,
that's
right?
That's him.
You could probably see that from fucking Polito, so like, you know. When the boys are not around and he's not paying attention or whatever the fuck, right? It could be like a week from now, a month from now. I mean, shit, bro. A bag? I'm good, brother. How about you don't get the truck for the rest of the day, man? Jesus. I keep going up.
Hopefully no one scooped it.
Nah, no way. Right there. Stop.
Fucking dumbass.
QCL.
Oh. Nah, I mean, we don't need more, so whatever. We'll get more later if we miss out on some, but the job is gonna be completed. That's all that matters. You know if we're able to put their bags into that or not?
Their bags?
That's their bag, not ours.
No, yeah, we're good.
Oh, nice, all right. Buster.
My juicer.
Wait, no.
Chat, what happened? You guys bailed on this voice. But I remember the tales the MC speedrun fails, watching our streamer flail. ID say it never got stale. Will it come back? The suspense has me biting my nails.
So how much is that total?
The money. There's 1,008. Keep the money.
E-money help. It's still good money though, thanks. I mean, it's still good money, you know? Bro.
Yeah, it's just a very slow run.
You know what the new, like fucking pawn shop, have you seen that? The whole new pawn shop thing?
The whole jewelry thing?
You know, I did the math on it, right?
Yeah,
a whole batch process every time is about 2.5 hours of pure work, and when you're done, if you do the math behind it, it's about $550 per hour in that 2.5 hours.
I don't know. 550 seems a little wrong.
I can show you the math behind it if you want. I was surprised too. Well,
my tablet is dead.
Damn, you can have mine if you want.
You want to do another one? Like normal bag run?
How good is that?
Can I get $140?
I a little love less time than nails what we just did right there. Well, so nails, like nails.
Boy, how much money is it?
$840 each.
That's not bad at all. Hey, yo, yeah, you guys got a tattoo or what?
No.
Yeah.
Yo, you should do a normal tier 3 cuz that's $1,400.
Normal tier 3s ain't bad.
Banned.
Yeah. It's just 40 bags.
Mhm. Jason.
ATM runs are great too, though. Yeah. Hey, Marty.
We just did that. You wouldn't happen to have a tablet on you by any chance? My just, friend, you know, over there was saying that you might be able to help me out with one.
Rolling with X these days.
Just use one.
Hey, well, look who it is. Look who it is.
I'm glad the war's over.
Yeah.
You're the best.
What do you mean, look who it is? What do you mean?
These guys just robbed us, I bet.
They just robbed you?
The blue truck, yeah.
Yeah, you know, let me hear that.
Well, so how did you I can give you a different outfit. It looks dope. I got like one in my truck. I'd have to pull it out.
You actually like it?
Oh, wait, you don't.
Actually, you got a knife?
Like it?
Yeah, I got a knife. Yeah.
Let me see it.
I think I'm gonna retire from the Rangers.
Wait, let me pull my truck.
I also have a bunker.
Oh. Why?
All right, you ready?
Wait, so I immediately. Hide behind.
Mr. XQC, the candles are telling me jokes, schizo.
Running through his car. Go ahead. Let's go.
Wait, is that his car? Hey, bruh.
Hey, what's good?
Can we get the bag back, bro? Not?
Hey, give us our bag back.
I didn't
buddy.
Take a bag.
No, you didn't.
When? I didn't rob you, did I?
Yeah, you took a bag out of it.
I did not take a bag. I held you up in the white shirt, did I not?
No.
I didn't rob you.
You were with him, bro. You took our bag.
I didn't take a bag.
Oh, you were with him.
Yeah, I was with him.
So you took collectively three bags. Took our shit.
We left you two bags.
Brody.
You Brother. Took three bags.
We should go to his friend then. Let's go to his friend.
Bro. You know what you do? Get out of a car and then kick the front me and you at the same time. Ready?
He's just in there, sitting there.
Hey, buddy! Yo, Marty, do that. Ready?
Yeah,
ready. Okay, I go in front of you at the back. Now.
Hey.
There you go.
Brother, listen. Listen. Yo, chill out, bro.
Brody.
Chill the fuck out.
We can talk this out, man. We can talk this out.
Listen.
Yeah, what's up?
Come on, come here, bitches. Come here. Go. You fucking moron. Come on.
He's in a big car.
Come on.
Too fast.
His car's almost broken. If he takes one bad turn and he crashes, his car's dead.
Car too fast.
Oh my god, bro, he's on Mars. Bro, he's already in Polito. What
I'm
the fuck is
BCB.
This? Oh my god. What the fuck?
He's gone. I gotta buy that fucking car.
I mean, let's be honest, bro. Listen. I think the manufacturer is probably gonna fucking crush some of the parts down for this bitch ass.
That car's expensive.
But the value on it is ridiculous. So I didn't want to buy a car like early on. I feel like some of the like the laws or whatever. Like it doesn't even make sense that an engine goes that fast, you know?
Yeah.
So this guy's a tier two. A truck, and he has like the most expensive car in the city.
I don't know.
Ridiculous.
Probably doesn't have a home or anything like that, though.
True.
But now what? You want to do the normal tier 2 job or what?
Oh, yeah, we can give it a run. We'll see how it goes. And let's be honest, man. The only thing that's VCB, bro, is his fucking aspirations to become anything else but this. Bro, he's stuck here for an eternity.
Okay.
He's being shady.
I don't know.
Yo,
know
whose van is that?
Someone in the truck?
Whose van is that up there?
I thought it was.
I think it might be Uno's.
I think that's Eli's.
Eli, is that your truck?
Anyone need two bags before I head off?
No.
I'll take them.
Well, you give them out?
Yeah, it's from us.
Bro, JP, you don't know, bro. There'd be like just 40 bags right here all the time.
Yeah,
man.
I don't need it. It's okay.
Yeah.
Here.
No, you get spares.
Well, I have two now.
Yeah, there's elevators over, and there's an elevator that has a bunch of us, those bags.
Yeah. If we get extra bags,
let's give this one back to Axe.
Yeah, sure.
What the fuck?
What?
I was looking at man.
Oh no, you can keep it. I don't give a fuck.
Excuse me.
Whoa! Anybody else there to me?
Louis, how do I find my house? How do I?
I know where it is. I know where it is.
I'm trying to.
Oh, okay. Never mind. Yeah. So how long is this run now?
Tier 3 slower.
Really?
Well, if you do tier 3 with 3 people, the second and third person, they get their pay like split up, right? So if the job pays 1,400, it's actually 700 each, unless you're the person that owns the truck. That makes sense?
Yeah.
And if you do 2-man tier 3, it's slower than doing just the tier 2s. Calculated, buddy. What are you doing?
I can't do window capture.
What's up, bitch? You got an issue, bruh? You got an issue? Come on, man. What's up? You gonna sit in your car, bro? You gonna sit in your car or what?
Nah, man. You keep doing your job, brother.
Hey, you too, man.
Keep doing your job.
Oh, yeah. Keep driving off, man.
Morana.
Yeah, come back. Here, boy. Here, boy. You want a treat?
This guy's funny. I mean, his car is one kick away, chat. One kick away. Hey, bro. His car is one kick away, so, I mean.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot if I need to put it in the back, yeah?
Yeah. You have a gun?
Nope. Lost it the other day. It was my fault. I forgot not to not be assaulted. Just a classic criminal mistake.
He's following. We actually got a fucking goddamn lapdog now.
That's kind of cute. I mean, what's he gonna do?
Security. No, he's literally just gonna sit there and watch. That's actually crazy.
I'm sure he's used to doing that. What a fucking loser. Bro, this cop Ruth, man. Holy man.
You got a crush?
Oh, hell no. I mean, kind of, maybe.
Oh. What's the problem with Ruth? Like
she is an absolute disgrace in the PD, bro. You should have seen the way she's been off the fucking rockers. Makes all the other fucking cops from before like look like nothing, you know? It makes them all look nice in comparison. Be crazy.
Stupid bitch. Look at him chasing. Bro, what you want, man? What you want, man? Look at him.
Hey, buddy boy.
What you want, man?
We're gonna call it quits or what?
Bro, you're the one fucking
chasing us.
You're
the one chasing us down.
I'm trying to talk, but you're just gonna kick my car.
All right, what do you want to talk about, man?
What's that behind us?
Look, the boys have rolled up, you see that?
Yo, what, are they fighting us for now?
Hey, the boys have rolled up. Don't kick, look, so you don't even want to talk.
Oh,
I'm just gonna have to stab you up then, yeah?
What do they want from you?
Well, I don't know what they want, this is so weird.
Wait, hey, rob them.
Hold on, they're not even moving and shit, hold on, yeah, you're right.
What do you want, bruh?
Oh, dude, you're gonna get, dude. What's up, bruh? What the fuck?
What?
Oh, what do they want?
Hey, hey, go in his fucking front seat and open the back door.
It's locked. Oh shit.
No, it's not. You open the door.
What's in this bitch? Nothing.
Really? That's so odd. Well, they acted so weird though, did it not?
Yeah, that was fucking strange.
Never seen that in my life, huh?
I swear they wanted to like give me something.
What if they're trying to hop on the back?
Why though?
I don't know. What the? 125. Oh, God. Let me put this in the glove box, hold on. I just don't get it. Guys, if this is like really not like really weird NPCs or not. What the hell? So how many can you do total of it on this?
What do you mean?
Like
how many bags can you carry?
Yeah, like a max runner.
24 bags, so $840.
Oh. Yeah, so these guys, like, it's like they got worried. Like, we got hit, right? And then it's not like we hit them or anybody hit them. We got hit and they came out. It's like they want to help us out.
Yeah, but the thing is they just stood there and then they walked back to their car. And then they turned back to look at us again. I don't know what the fuck that was.
I have no idea.
Yeah, I have no idea. That's so weird.
I mean, it's like, maybe it's like our locals, like they're like security.
Yeah, maybe.
Cause that one had a gun. You see it?
Fuck them up. Yeah, yeah. I think they both had guns.
Maybe they were being nice. Maybe I'm the one that's rude all the time.
Rude, gaslighter, crazy, strange.
Oh, I'm not a gaslighter. What the heck?
Oh yeah, you're not a gaslighter. You definitely.
I would never.
That I'm the devil, when actually I just didn't do anything wrong. Yeah, no, I remember that part.
Why, if you're gonna speak like that, it seems like you're gaslighting. Now you're like probably one of the best self-gaslighter then.
Maybe there's some sort of confusion. Maybe you gaslight yourself. What have I done wrong to the company other than the fucking locks?
Well, not much. Why?
Nothing, right?
Well, we never said anything wrong, did we?
Buddy, you destroyed my car.
Wait, when?
You took my car, towed it from my home, threw it around, took all the doors, threw it around like it's a damn piñata!
Wait, you found it?
Bitch, and I didn't say shit about it. You know why? Because you live in your little fucking headspace, your little fucking bubble of comfort of people telling you yes, 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 yes.
You said you
But don't sit here and act like I've steered you wrong, alright? Don't.
Listen. You did a bunch of small things here and there, right? Like
you wanted me to fuck over the company and pulling me along on a fucking string, and then when I didn't want to fuck them over,
you did some little things.
I know.
You did some like crazy ex behavior, bro. Come on, man.
No, the fuck I didn't.
Really?
No, the fuck I didn't. Because you wanted me to fuck over a bunch of people, and then you gaslit all of them into thinking I was a bad person. Yeah. Fuck.
Well, sometimes I wonder, like, what are the motives here?
Hey, I wonder the same thing about you.
Because you need to understand, like, I had no ship to jump to.
There wasn't supposed to be, there wasn't a ship to jump to. You don't remember the talk you had?
A good sailor, right? A good sailor can sail on his captain's ship. A great sailor can sail on anybody's ship. You understand how that works?
What the hell are you talking about?
What that means is, being a good sailor would have been like, let's say, we hop off the ship, whatever, right? That's cool and all, yeah? But then you stop sailing. Until you found another ship to jump to, right? Don't jump. Why bother?
Bitch. Did you forget what the fuck we accomplished? We are the fucking ship.
Unfortunately, right? It's impossible to predict, right? How things will shape up. And you need to understand it. We didn't want to be stranded. Like, you can't do that. Like, the day you got mad at us, right? What if there was more to it? Or what if that day came 5 days later with something bigger, right? We would have had nothing. Would not have been able to do anything. Would have been just completely stuck. Just our fucking thumbs in our asses doing nothing.
Okay.
Is that?
Okay, so? Listen, that's not the point I'm making.
What is the point I'm making?
The point I'm making is you're out here fucking driving off Legion Square Bank saying, you're not loyal, Marty. Bitch, you're not the one. You're the one that's not fucking loyal.
How not?
You're the one that's not loyal.
How not? Don't hand me. Give me an answer instead of hand me.
You're the one that abandoned me. You're the one that left me.
Are you sure about that?
You're the one.
Are you sure about that? How many more can we do?
Four more back. Maybe
listen,
you're the one that changed.
I am a leader by nature. Okay. If I did the,
no
if
the
I,
fuck
if
you're
I
not.
If I did things the way.
What the f- No the fuck you're not.
Oh man, I mean, if you can't agree with that, then we have nothing to talk about.
Okay, let's just assume, all right, okay. Yeah, you're a leader by nature, all right, continue.
If I let us out too early and we failed, I would have been a terrible leader. And I would have taken the whole blame for it, all of it, 100%.
That's not the point, okay? I'm not telling you should have left or whatever, this, that, okay? What I'm saying is, right, you told me you wanted to fuck them over, right? And I didn't want to fuck them over, so I parted ways, right? And then I worked some shit out, and I'm like, yo, I'll come back, this, that. Everyone agreed. I pull up, and you're throwing me to the fucking side.
For what? You forgot how that happened. Sometimes you just have to look a certain way and kind of do what it takes, right?
Okay.
Right? Unfortunately, I didn't feel that during that day. From you, you were not giving me that energy. You were not the Marty that just does whatever it needs to, right? To get to where we're trying to go. And it's why I try to tell all the interns, it's why I try to teach them a resourcefulness. You can find things, gather things, whatever that is, information, behavior, do whatever it takes, right? To get to the finish line. And it's what these guys do, you understand? And on that day, you gave me a hint that energy, you didn't have that. And it's one of those things, right? Like, it's kind of like retirement. You think about retirement, it means you're already retired, right? If that energy wasn't in you, right? Like, I just felt it's not gonna be back for a good amount of time. So I don't wanna have you on board. It's the root thought. It's kind of like
if the beginning is corrupted, the rest is, will be corrupted. It's like a cancerous cell that multiplies.